Pro-life groups are calling on members of Congress to protect the long-standing Hyde Amendment. For the first time in decades, every single House Democrat recently voted to strip the Hyde Amendment from federal health funding. What started off as a bipartisan amendment years ago is now very clearly partisan on Capitol Hill today. The Hyde Amendment bans the taxpayer funding of abortion. Since it was established in 1976, the Hyde Amendment is credited with saving over 2 million unborn lives. However, Democrats today claim the Hyde Amendment is racist and say they want to get rid of it. Here is House Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
I mean, I myself have been an opponent of the Hyde Amendment long before I came to Congress. As soon as the Hyde Amendment was there, I was thinking, how can we get rid of that? So it's long overdue getting rid of it.
While pro-life Democrats are rare in D.C. today, there are pro-life Democrats active in state politics, including Louisiana State Senator Katrina Jackson. She's spoken at the March for Life multiple times, and her pro-life law was even taken up at the Supreme Court last year. I sat down with Jackson at Live Action's recent Life Awards Gala, where she was honored, and spoke to her about the trend of Democrats today and how she responds to claims the Hyde Amendment is racist. Louisiana State Senator Katrina Jackson, thank you so much for your time today.
Thanks for having me.
It's a joy to see you in person here. You are a leading voice in the pro-life movement, and you are a pro-life Democrat. Pro-life Democrats are more and more rare these days, but is it more common in Louisiana?
It is. We right now have a pro-life governor and even our first lady advocates for the pro-life movement and for babies. Probably half and half now. Used to be a majority of Democrats in the House and the Senate collectively are pro-life, but it's still the same stigma when you're out and about in public. But Louisiana, you know, everyone says Louisiana politics is different, and usually they say it in a negative manner, but in the area of pro-life and Christianity and standing for what we believe in, that's our positive. And I tell people that that's where we come into commonality across party lines.
Wow, that's incredible. As a pro-life Democrat, I'm curious to your reaction that the first time ever recently, every single Democrat in the House of Representatives voted against the Hyde Amendment, which would prevent the taxpayer funding of abortion. No House Democrat supported the Hyde Amendment. What's your reaction to that?
Of course, I was shocked. I was even more disappointed that some Democrats advocated that it was racist for us not to repeal the Hyde Amendment. And look, I sit in a room with African-American women every day. 60% of my district is African-American. I serve 7 of the 64 parishes in Louisiana because for some reason, my district is huge in land mass, probably one of the few Senate districts that have seven parishes. I've never been in a group of African-Americans who've asked me to fund abortion. And that was really disappointing that they used that, and it was just true. It was really false. You couldn't have believed it. You couldn't have believed it coming out of your own mouth. Right now in the African-American community, people are still screaming for equitable education and access to health care. And what I've said in my message has been this: it's racist to fund abortions because you're going to have to cut the budget somewhere at every level of government. In order to spend more money, unless more revenue comes in, you cut the budget somewhere. In Louisiana, generally, we have a deficit. We have to cut education and health care. The two things that the African-American community is screaming about, and amongst others, but so it was disappointing to say the least, but to gear it toward African-Americans and the need to fund abortion was totally erroneous. I've never been in a church, never been in a black setting, a black meeting, or any organizational meeting where people were saying, you need to fund my abortion. What we're screaming for right now in the African-American community all over this country is, of course, things like healthcare, education, having a seat at the table, business, economic development. And so to use that to pass this amendment was very to pass this repeal was very disappointing.
Our U.S. President, President Joe Biden, is a fellow Democrat. He long supported the Hyde Amendment up until recently, 2019, I believe. If you had the chance to speak with our president, what would your message be to him?
I would say to him that when he was campaigning, he told us he was going to be work across party lines. He was going to work for America and not panter toward one side or the other on social issues. Repealing the Hyde Amendment and supporting that is pandering to the extreme left on this issue. It's also opening up the floodgates to cut later. in education, healthcare, social services, and things that he also advocates for. And I would tell him that those who voted for him or his base didn't ask him to fund abortion. He's listening to a small segment of America, a extremely small segment of America, who are asking him to do this. And he needs to listen to the voice collectively of a whole in America. I passed the, and I would say to him this, the constitutional amendment that Louisiana doesn't recognize the right to abortion or government-funded abortion. Going across the state talking to people, because it was a constitutional amendment that the people had to vote on, even pro-choice choice people believe that we should not fund abortion. And so I would say that to him, that he really needs to hit the ground, talk to people. I know COVID is going on, but just listening to the voice of America, and America's not asking for Congress or the United States or the federal government to fund abortion. We're asking to fund those things that build businesses, keep people in their homes, right, at this time. And that's what I would say.
I hope you have that opportunity to have that conversation. You are a national pro-life leader. You have spoken at the National March for Life stage. Here I am speaking with you at Live Action's Life Awards, where you are receiving an honor tonight. You are a Louisiana state senator. Would you ever be open to running for the U.S. Senate or U.S. Congress?
This is what I tell people. I'm very sincere in this, and I know some people think it's a cliche. I only move when God tells me to move in politics. Politics is a strange beast. And when you invite it into your life, you have to have the protection of the Holy Spirit. So I don't consider anything that God doesn't option me to do. What I will say is that I haven't felt led to run. I hadn't felt led to go to the national level. I am happy serving the people of Louisiana and being a voice in any way I can for babies. And so unless God says something, unless God options me, I'm happy where I am.
My last question to you is, as I mentioned, here we are at Live Action's Life Awards, and you are receiving this honor. What does that mean to you, and where have you felt God during this time as you've been advocating for life?
I feel him in everything and in life, because I just remember reading the scripture one day, and I tell people this at 20-some years old, and I was away from my family and was in law school and was in a church, Faith, Hope, and Love Worship Center in Baton Rouge, that was really just teaching the meat of the word. And my pastor was, we were studying Proverbs, and I get the scripture that 10 things that God hate. One of those is the shedding of innocent blood. And he said an abortion is the shedding of innocent blood. And when you truly make up your mind to hate what God hates and to love what God loves and to love people regardless of their decisions, but to be bold enough to say, listen, this is not a decision we should make. You feel God in everything you do. That is the basis for why I'm pro-life. I can't move without him. I can't speak to you without him in the pro-life arena. It's something I feel like is your minister of government. And if God places you here, you're here to advocate for what he wants and what he believes in and for the people. And so being pro-life is just that. It's a ministry.
Well, I'm so grateful for your leadership, and congratulations on your award.
Thank you.
Louisiana State Senator Katrina Jackson, thank you.
Thank you.